and strength. That's why you choose Pacific Life. Rely on the strength of Pacific Life, proud sponsor of the Pacific Life Open.
For over 70 years, our graduates have gone on to bigger and better things. They become well-paid technology professionals and Little League coaches, distinguished business executives, and soccer moms. It's in all of these accomplishments that DeVry University takes great pride, because if the true measure of a university is in the success of its graduates, then we're not just helping to build careers, we're helping to build communities. DeVry University is in your neighborhood, in your corner, with four-year bachelor's degree programs that take just three, in technology or business. Master's degrees from our Keller Graduate School of Management, and a team of advisors that take more than just a passing interest in your future. So our doors will be wide open, days, nights, and weekends, because everyone has promises to keep, besides the ones they make to themselves. Call 1-800-DEVRY-11 today and see what your local university can do for you. DeVry University. Think ahead.
The second half of the season is here as the Sharks find themselves swimming upstream. The Sharks savor some home ice time as they take on Daryl Sutter's Flames. Sharks and Flames, Saturday at 7:30 on Fox Sports Net.
We are back, Staples Center, downtown Los Angeles, the Pacific Life Pac-10 Tournament. And let's take you one more time around the country. We mentioned Upset City. We got another one for you in the ACC second half. North Carolina looking for the upset. Jawad Williams gets the ball. He's going to throw it down with a huge jam. He had a career-high 25 points. Matt Doherty loving it. Maryland, the defending national champion, they are out. Tar Heels also got 20 points and 10 boards from Raymond Felton. A career-high 19 points from Melvin Scott. Terrapins have not won the ACC tournament since 1984. We're going to see you at the half. Dan Belwamany and I will take you around the country with more scores and highlights. We'll also have the Bank of America, Alaska Airlines million-mile shot, and we'll have analysis and stats and much, much more at the half. Back downstairs, Steve Fizziak.
Thank you, Bill McDonald. If you are a high seed, be afraid. Be very afraid. The Lexus leader trying to win this tournament. I mean, four of the last 5 years, the tournament winners have won the NCAA championship. Maryland was the only team to lose their tournament. That was last year when Duke won and moved on. 2001, Duke won the ACC. 2000, Michigan State, the Big Ten tournament. Connecticut won in 99. Kentucky in 98. Covey Smith won his first title. And there is Ernie Kent. He would love to win it. You know, he loves the tournament because he said, hey, last year we won the Pac-10 title but lost in the tournament. I still believe this is a wonderful experience for the kids. It's a great recruiting tool. And he said, for 3 days, it's a great promotion for the Pac-10 conference.
And Ben Braun told us the exact same thing at their practice earlier today. You come down, you enjoy L.A., you get a chance to sharpen your team against teams that know you extremely well. Ryan Hollins trying to go for the hook shot, gets tied up. But, you know, Ryan Hollins a little bit quicker on the move. He had a one dribble jump shot in the paint, a little bit too deliberate with that last possession. But once again, UCLA, they've got to stay quick with their offensive execution, not get into this meandering, pass it around the perimeter five times before we look for a shot.
Here's Jason Capono taking it right under the teeth of Andre Joseph's defense, and it's a three-point UCLA lead.
Well, that's 6-3 against 6-8. You know, Capono against Joseph. You've got those mismatches all over the floor for UCLA.
Bruins have to feel good up three, and Capono, their top scorer, only with 4 points tonight.
The Bruins have got to feel bad about their defense, especially perimeter defense against Davis, against Ridenour. They have really hurt them. That's the adjustment they need to make.
Joseph trying to get baseline, denied by Collins. Shot clock down to 7. Lincoln.
That's a nice move.
And yeah. Swatted out of bounds by T.J. Cummings. There will be 3 seconds in the shot clock when they inbounds.
Catch that.
We're at the Staples Center for the Pacific Life Pac-10 semifinals. 8-seed UCLA, 5-seed Oregon. Anderson's got to shoot. And he misses the three-pointer. Capono.
He There you go. And then for UCLA, once again in transition. That's where they are playing best. And then you get the added bonus of getting the crowd so much more into this game. That's a nice move by Brandon Lincoln, but T.J. Cummings, you know, he gets the oohs and the ahs, but if you catch the basketball, you get the possession. And even though Anderson didn't miss that shot as the shot clock was down to three.
Jason Capono yesterday, first half, had 15. He's a guy with great skills. Against Oregon this year, he's been like a little girl with a curl in the middle of the forehead. One game he was very, very good with 21. The next night he only scored 5 in a 31-point defeat. You can see UCLA dominating at the free throw line, and they have been there 12 more times than Oregon. Bruins by 4.
And Ray Young adjusts his defense and meets Rittenour at midcourt. That's the respect that he's got to show him. Pac-10 player of the year, 20 points a game. He can't go into any screens. Got to break that time. He'll get burned eventually.
Jackson fine rebound. Gets it back to Rittenour. He's long with his shot. Johnson gets it. We've got a minute and a half remaining in the first half. Here's Davis. Wings it inside to Jackson. No foul called as Jackson took it to the hoop and was hit on the arm. Rittenour with the save behind his back to Jackson. Davis for 3.
Momentum for Oregon. Great job, Rittenour, with the steal, the flip from behind his back. Ryan Hollins, the shot blocker, goes out with a closeout that makes him about 6 feet tall instead of closer to 7 feet tall. Yeah, again, fly out of James Davis, jump in the air. Don't do that closeout they teach you in practice. Block the shot. What a great play by Rittenour.
Jackson on Capono. Rims out, no good. There's still plenty of time left. Let's see how they push it. Davis, Jackson, off the side of the iron, but they get it back. Rittenour to fire. I thought he might go for the final shot of the half, and UCLA steals it from Johnson. And Steve Lavin just screamed out at Ray Young. One shot, one shot.
And one shot.
I think number 34 is taking it.
And I got the shot, coach. Again, he's got a smaller player. Let's see if Oregon doubles to help out James Davis on penetration. That's a good move. That's a good move, Steve.
Unbelievable first half for Ray Young.
Wow, that almost went
18 for Young. UCLA by 3. A Young hitting his last 6 field goals of the first half.
And this is a little hang number right there. Going to hang the Larry Bird look-alike. Knocks down the jumper. That's a tough, tough shot by Ray Young.
Let's go to Bill McDonald.
Thank you so much, Steve. This game's so reminiscent of the first meeting between these two that went overtime. Ray Young out of his mind in the first half. Down to Jim Watson with Steve Lavin.
Billy Mack, that is exactly the story of the first half. That's all I'm going to ask you. What has gotten into Ray Young?
Well, he's in the zone. Been reading that book on mastery by George Leonard. It's got him on the path of improvement, and we're just kind of riding him right now. But we've got to get more balanced scoring, obviously, and we got to work for easier shots. We've made some tough shots, as has Oregon. Got to do a better job in transition. They're tough to guard. If you go man-to-man on them, they can really slice you up. But if you go zone, they shoot the ball over the perimeter. So we're just going to have to mix our defenses, and we've got to get a more balanced attack in terms of inside now and getting more guys distributing the ball.
Appreciate your time, Steve. I'll let you get in the locker room. How about it, Billy Mack? Ray Young last night, the hero, 17 points first half tonight. How about 18? Bruins up at the break.
Dan Belwamany, what is Ray Young right now?
Ray Young's out of his mind.
You got that. We're back with highlights from around the country after this.
Mayfair strange in the morning light. Mayfair strange in a summer night. Mayfair strangest in the afternoon.
Yesterday, one of our advisors showed this woman how even if her brother outlives her, she can always be there for him.
Two men were found half a mile from here. They were killed with a hatchet.
He didn't use a hatchet, he used a knife.
Today, Alan's battle stress has become part of his personality. And it's impossible to reverse.
How many more years and I can stop him?
Tommy Lee Jones, Benicio Del Toro.
If you cross this line, you better be ready to kill me.
The Hunted. Rated R. Starts today in theaters everywhere.
This is a pipe. This is a comedian's dream.
I wish it was on Comedy Central's premium blend.
Only that's not a pipe dream. Thanks to Comedy Central's Laugh Riot stand-up competition, comedians have a chance at their big break. To enter, go to ComedyCentral.com for complete rules. Then send us a tape of your act. The best comics will compete for a spot on premium blend and much more. Comedy Central Laugh Riot, not a pipe dream.
Brought to you locally by VHICS.com, your roadmap to the automotive world.
They're more than groundbreaking and beyond original. They're HBO's award-winning series and outstanding movies. The best on HBO. And on Cinemax, count on exclusive premieres, the biggest hits, and the most movies with the fewest repeats. Plus, with Comcast Digital Cable, you get multiple channels of HBO and Cinemax. The best, the most, yours with Comcast Digital Cable, HBO, and Cinemax.
Get digital cable with HBO and Cinemax for only $9.95 more a month for 3 months. Call 1-888-824-8089.
Best damn sports show, period. Weeknights on Fox Sports Net.
We're back at Staples Center, Fox Sports Net, bringing it to you live. The Pacific Light Pac-10 tournament. We've reached halftime, our first semifinal this evening, and the Bruins of UCLA on top of the Ducks of Oregon as UCLA hopes again to keep their season alive and forge their way into the final. Big 12 action. Oklahoma, Colorado. Early first half. Quanis White finds Kevin Bookout. Spins. Hits the hook. Oklahoma up by three early on. Big 12, such an outstanding region. Let's take a look at the bracket there. Right now in the first half, Sooners, the number three seed on top of the Buffs, 28-18. As you can see, Kansas is already through in the big upset today so far. Texas losing.
Yeah,
there.
Texas Tech, Bobby Knight, certainly tough in the tournament. You see Kansas and Missouri moving on.
To the SEC, Kentucky, no surprise there, taking care of Vandy. And we wait now on Tennessee and Auburn to see who joins Mississippi State in the semis. Now, ACC, first half, Virginia looking good. Travis Watson gets the ball, lays it up, plus the foul, and one. Virginia up early by three. We'll have an update for you right now. And the Blue Devils of Duke down 13-9. The ACC, Dan, this is the first day of their full tournament.
Yeah, first day of the tournament, Wake Forest, NC State moving on. I like Wake Forest. I get a chance to win the tournament.
Yeah, that's a big win for NC State, too. Ohio State and Michigan State are through to the semis. The Illini, now we wait on Indiana. The Atlantic 10, Xavier. They are into the final. No surprise there.
No surprise. Remember, John Chaney started 0-5, defeat Xavier.
You know, it's going to be quite some game if they get Dayton and Xavier. Those would be the two favorites going into the Atlantic 10. We welcome you back to our Pac-10 perch. And, you know, Dan, if the folks are just joining us, this is a great game here, UCLA and Oregon, but seeds are falling all over the country. It's upset Friday.
Well, you know, it's tournament time. And obviously, you look at Arizona, they lose. Florida loses. Texas loses. Wisconsin loses. Stanford, you can go all the way down the line. I mean, so many losses, and of course, Maryland just loses. So the fact of the matter is, anybody can win now, so it's up for grabs.
You know, the bug hit here yesterday. Number one and two out, Arizona and Stanford. We've got UCLA up by three, 45-42 at the half. We continue from Staples Center in a moment.
There he was. My heart began to race. Had too much time gone by for us? Then I saw a sign, and I knew that soon he would take me in his arms and tell me the words I'd been longing to hear.
Hey, scones. Thanks, honey.
Introducing the V8-powered GX, the all-new luxury utility vehicle from Lexus.
At Rent-A-Center, it's easy to get the stuff you want because everybody's pre-approved. TVs, appliances, furniture, computers, you can get it today. Boom! Just like that.
No credit? Boom! No problem!
No credit? Boom! You're in!
No credit? Boom! You got it!
Hey, you guys can't say boom. Get your own word.
Now mention this ad and get a week free when you pay for a week. Call 1-800-205-2005 for Rent-A-Center.
Pow!
Nope, keep thinking.
A terrifying force has arrived on Earth. It has the power to assume any human form.
You're not Jonesy.
And destroy all human life.
I'll show you things you wish you'd never seen.
Dreamcatcher, rated R, starts March 21st.
Mrs. Mark.
Hi, honey.
Hey, what's up?
Do you know where your clippers are?
I don't know. In the garage?
Uh-uh.
I'm in a meeting now. Can we do it in a toolbox, maybe?
No.
The closet. Oh, no, Landon?
Uh-huh.
Is he all right?
Yeah.
Oi.
See, that's what I'm talking about.
T-Mobile camera phones. Get more.
Okay. I'll take Chris's buddy. You playing that?
Why not?
Look up, see blue. Levant Blue.
Totally NASCAR. Your season-long destination for everything that is NASCAR. Weeknights on Fox Sports Net.
At 24 Hour Fitness, you'll find everything under one roof, including all the latest classes, from yoga to cycling to kickboxing. Get 50% off enrollment fee, 50% off your renewal. Call 1-800-204-2400. There are month-to-month memberships. We even have kids clubs. Call 1-800-204-2400 now for this limited-time offer. We have over 300 locations and one near you. 24 Hour Fitness. Why go anywhere else?
The Pacific Life Pac-10 College Basketball Tournament on Fox Sports Net is being brought to you by Pacific Life, offering insurance, annuities, and investments. Rely on the strength of Pacific Life. By Lexus, the endless pursuit of perfection. And by Rent-A-Center. To get the best name brands like Sony, Whirlpool, Philips, Dell, and more, go to Rent-A-Center today. We're at Staples Center, downtown Los Angeles. Great game going on here. Just as clarification, by the way, in the A-10, Xavier lost to Temple in that one right here. UCLA on top of Oregon. See you in a minute.
To make sure they're authentic, I brought my new fish and big chips to an English pub.
What sort is this?
My new fish and big chips. Tender Alaskan fish fillets with authentic chips. Big wedge cut potatoes and the traditional malt vinegar. What do you think?
Right then, the chips, what you Yanks call fries, sound as a pound, top notch, Bob's your uncle. Whilst the fish, what you blokes call?
Fish.
It's brilliant, mate. Spot on. Tickety boo. It's yummy. Blimey, mate. You're paler than I am.
When you think about the most important moments in your life, what were you wearing? Every man should own at least one suit. We invite you to buy yours from us.
100% wool suits, starting at $200.
You're gonna like the way you look. I guarantee it.
Men's Warehouse. To contact the store nearest you, call 1-800-776-SUIT.
On Sunday, March 23rd, the race formerly known as the Houlihan's 12K enters its 20th year with a new name, Across the Bay 12K. And nothing has changed but the name. From Sausalito to San Francisco, across the Golden Gate Bridge, Across the Bay 12K offers the same stunning course. For the 20th consecutive year, race founder Dave Rohde and his sponsors will treat you to a world-class post-race celebration on Fisherman's Wharf. Across the Bay 12K, Sunday, March 23rd. Join the celebration.
Need to stand out? Get into a 2003 Chevy Silverado. From the half-ton model, with over 4 tons of available towing capability when properly equipped, to the available Duramax diesel. Now get $3,000 total cash back for GM and non-GM owners. That's $2,000 cash back plus $1,000 GM loyalty cash. Chevy Silverado. Designed for whatever you do. See your local Chevy dealer today.
It's sale time at Les Schwab.
If ever there was a time to buy tires, this is it. We've got just what you need, in stock and on sale. Like to travel on road or off? You'll find the perfect tire at a great sale price. Selected custom wheels, batteries, and shocks on sale too, including our popular RMX. Plus, our biggest strut assembly sale ever, $50 off per pair installed.
Some of our best savings of the year are happening right now, right here at the Les Schwab site.
Back Fox Sports Net, the Pacific Life Pac-10 Tournament. We're at halftime, and the Bruins trying to make an improbable run into the NCAA tourney behind Rae Young, leading at the half over the Ducks of Oregon, 45-42. And a little bit earlier, our friends at Bank of America and Alaska Airlines sponsored the Million Miles' shot, and Jeffrey Howell made that free throw and then had an opportunity to shoot from half court. For more on this, let's go to Jim Watson.
All right, Billy, thank you very much. Of course, the players and the coaches get most of the attention here at Staples Center during the tournament, but without the great sponsors, none of this is possible. Ann Artizone from Alaska Airlines and Dean Kowalski from Bank of America. And tell us about the new Pac-10 Hoopla Sweepstakes. What's this about?
The Bank of America Alaska Airlines Visa Platinum Hoopla Sweepstakes gave us the opportunity to demonstrate the fantastic partnership that we have, the Pac-10 Conference, Alaska Airlines, and Bank of America.
And Ann, of course, Alaska Airlines is involved in this as well.
Yes, it was a great opportunity for us to partner with Bank of America. With our presence up and down the West Coast, it was a perfect fit for us. Plus, with our new service to the East Coast, Boston, New York, Washington, D.C., Miami, and now Orlando, it's a better deal than ever.
All right, Ann Artizone from Alaska Airlines, Dean Kowalski from Bank of America, making it all possible. Back upstairs to Billy Mack.
Thank you so much, James. Ray Young with a big first half. Will he continue? Will he get some help? And can UCLA stop Luke Ridnour? We'll see when Steve and Marcus rejoin you after the break.
Get it nice and clean.
I think we're going to finish the roof today.
AMPM is proud to be the official convenience store of the Pac-10 Conference.
What's that?
The fence.
Now, Skip developed an interesting habit at work last week, didn't you, Skip? All of a sudden, he has to print everything in color. I tell him, Skip, it's about the money. Even our white papers are in color.
Actually, Mr. Arnold, color isn't that expensive anymore. There's even an affordable color printer that's faster than 90% of the printers out there. Skip's ahead of the curve.
The Home Depot is more than a store. It's a powerhouse with powerful names and tools for mowing, blowing, edging, or just riding with the wind. It's the guaranteed low price. And right now, it's no payments or interest until January 2004 when you make any John Deere tractor, Toro, or Honda mower purchase of $299 or more with your Home Depot credit card. It's the power to turn the outdoors into the great outdoors. The Home Depot. You can do it. We can help.
Stuart Waltrip, the track too tough to take. Live from Darlington this weekend.
Danielle, can you find another place for your backpack?
Unlimited online bill paying.
Mom, movie star.
Free from Bank of America.
Right there.
Higher standards.
The Pacific Life Pac-10 College Basketball Tournament on Fox Sports Net is being brought to you by Pacific Life, offering insurance, annuities, and investments. Rely on the strength of Pacific Life. By the document company Xerox, there's a new way to look at it. And by the Alaska Airlines Visa Platinum Card, the most popular way to earn miles in the Pac-10.
We are at the Staples Center for the Pacific Life Pac-10 Tournament Semifinals. UCLA has a 3-point lead over the Oregon Ducks. Our Yamaha stats show you exactly what's taking place. And the free throw disparity shows you that UCLA is really working Oregon inside.
Yeah, doing a great job getting to the free throw line. UCLA, the outstanding field goal percentage, but they need more shots. And for Oregon, you know, Luke Jackson just 4 points at halftime. You know that he's about to bust loose, that he's going to score more than four, going to get double figures, high double figures.
And Jason Capono, only five. Let's go to Jim Watson.
Fizz and Marcus, I talked to Ernie Kent coming out of the Oregon locker room, and the first two words he said to me are, Ray Young, how do we stop Ray Young? And then he mentioned that they took way too many three-pointers, Oregon did. 18 three-pointers, bad shots. They got to get the ball inside, defensively keep UCLA out of transition.
We go to the second half. Oregon in white, UCLA in the blue. Jackson, Ridnour, Cross White, Johnson, and Davis getting the start. Davis hit three of his four shots, but UCLA was hurting him on the offensive end when he was having to defend. The Bruins going with Young, Collins, Patterson, DeJon Thompson, and Jason Capono.
Davis a wide open shot on that attempt. Nice pass. Couldn't finish. Brian Holland.
Great save by Johnson as he was losing control of the basketball. And now UCLA steals it right back. That is the eighth turnover by Oregon.
If I'm Ray Young, I see James Davis. I'm taking him a couple of dribbles to the middle of the court and trying to jump right over him. That's the best offense you're going to get.
Capono running one-handed. No. Patterson, good rebounder, hooks it back up and in.
Nice job. Andre with the bailout save on the offensive rebound. And again for Oregon, no block out.
No.
Give me that. Give that to me.
Young. 4-3. Who is this guy? Who is this masked man?
The only problem, he was 6-for-7 at halftime. He's got to take more shots.
I don't even think he knows who he is.
He said he hadn't had this much fun, Ray Young, since middle school.
He has hit 7-of-8 from the floor. Missed his first shot by about 2 feet. He has been dead center perfect the rest of the way.
Okay, I'll take Chris's buddy. You playing that?
Why not?
Look up, see blue, Labatt Blue.
This week on Home Makeover, we're at the home of Brad and Steffi Gill. Steffi wrote in that their garage needed help, but money's tight. So let's get to work. All right, take a look.
Oh, wow, I love it. What a difference.
Right now, you can get every Yamaha motorcycle and ATV for just 3.9% APR all the way to 2005. Plus, get up to $300 customer cash on select models. And just look at the results. Next week, we renovate a kitchen without spending a bundle. See you, folks.
Every day, thousands of Californians come to Cache Creek, where winning is everything, where we've just added 500 new slots. Don't forget, blackjack, bingo, poker, and Pai Gow poker. Plus, new members receive a free gift and a free $1 million slot pool for joining the Cache Club. Come to Cache Creek Indian Bingo and Casino in the heart of the Capay Valley off Highway 16, where winning is everything.
Set in the dynamic, diverse city of Los Angeles, UCLA is where dreams are realized, ideas are born, and obstacles are overcome. Every day, our faculty and students raise the bar for research and results. Every day, our community extends beyond campus. Every day, the competition feels the heat of Bruin Athletics, a sun-drenched campus buzzing with an energy all its own. UCLA, experience excellence every day.
UCLA with an 8-point lead 4 weeks ago. Marcus Johnson, Ray Young was averaging 4 points per game. What's happened?
Well, you know, he was inserted as a starting point guard. His confidence soared after a couple of good games. Hits that big three-pointer, puts in the game in OT, and has just carried over to this game today. Ended the first half with that little hanging Michael Jordan-esque kind of fadeaway. And then just a moment ago, Yaka pulling it up in transition. 7-for-8 field goals. He needs more shots. You've got to be selfish if you're Ray Young and shooting the basketball this well.
Steve Henson of the LA Times said Ray Young has just read the book Mastery, the Keys to Success and Long-Term Fulfillment. It worked for him. Here is James Davis going right side, Luke Ridnour. Jackson inside, cross white. He was stumbled and hit by a Bruin, but no foul called, and we're going UCLA's way. Our virtual coach answer, the question was, will UCLA pull off the upset again today? 50-50. There is Steve Lavin, the embattled Steve Lavin, who came in with a record of 10-18. If you want to go online and answer our questions, foxsports.com on Lycos. Keyword is Pac-10.
Now, DeJon Thompson got the diminutive James Davis on him. He's 6'7". Davis is 5'10". Good job taking him to the basket, drawing the foul.
And this is where there is a free throw disparity, because UCLA has gone inside more than Oregon has. And this will be their 20th free throw attempt to just four for Oregon. Take this opportunity to sign up for the Alaska Airlines Visa Platinum Card from Bank of America and earn miles everywhere you use it. You'll get 5,000 bonus miles upon approval, not to mention 2,000 bonus miles every year after that. So go to alaskavisa.com, Pac-10, and take your shot. Thompson gives UCLA their biggest lead of the night, 52-42.
And this is the stage of the game when again, the two Lukes, especially Luke Jackson, has been extremely quiet. They look for him to get a lot more aggressive, trying to create off the dribble. He's defended by Jason Capono.
And a foul is called.
I mean, Capono works hard on defense, but Luke Jackson has played well against UCLA, to say the least. That's the understatement of the year.
Ray Young, second personal foul.
And now, Rick, you know, you don't want to pick up that third one on a cheapie if you're Ray Young, as well as you shoot the basketball.
Jackson saves his own mistake. Joseph corner Jackson, but well covered by Jason Capone. Andre Joseph wide open for three.
Junior college transfer, Andre Joseph, nice job. Spotting up, good screen. Ryan Hollis, tough time getting out, and Tyronzik knocks it down. That's his given name, Tyronzik. Andre Joseph.
Thompson was looking low for Patterson, but he was well defended by Johnson. Oregon staying in that zone. And Thompson goes right over Jay Anderson and scores. UCLA has just been playing some marvelous basketball, and we have a foul called on Jason Capono, who is riding Luke Ridenour along the baseline.
No need for that. No need for that foul by Capono against Ridenour, but watch Tyronzik, Andre Joseph. Tyronzik knocks it down dead corner. He told me, please don't tell anybody that's my given first name, and I'm not telling many people, just a few special friends of mine.
You're just between you and me.
Me and you, the whole of America.
But Marcus, I agree with you, the fact that why would Jason Capone do that?
That's not good.
Oregon is going to set a record this year in free throw shooting, 78%. You do not want to have them get the bonus that early.
And Charlie Range, the lead official out here, starting to call a lot of the arm fouls, the holding fouls, the upper body fouls. You got to move your feet if you're UCLA. That's three on Andre Patterson. And stop reaching, stop gambling. The officials are starting to tighten up with the whistle.
Ridenour finds Robert Johnson somehow. He drew three defenders, and then the kick beautifully.
He suckered the freshman beautifully. Ryan Hollins just kind of waited. He saw Ridenour at the last moment, thought he was going to shoot the basketball after he left his feet, but now it was passing all the way.
But they've really been able to deny most of Ridenour's dribble penetration. Offensive rebound by Thompson, back up and in. UCLA is just playing lights out on the boards. They have really hurt Oregon rebounding.
And they've got the size advantage in a lot of different positions, and they've got to use that to their benefit. They're starting, and they've done that most of the game. Ray Young shooting the ball, now offensive rebounding by Dijon Thompson.
High low, Jackson Johnson, and Johnson is fouled by UCLA. Patterson, if that's against Andre, that will be number four.
And here's using the freshman right there. Come on, big fella, jump, jump. Nobody slides down from the weak side to defend Robert Johnson. An easy gimme inside, but all set up by the craftiness, the creativity of Luke Ridenour. 11 points, 6 assists on the evening.
Well, Patterson had a look on his face like he was really in pain. He's like, oh no, did I commit the foul? He did not. They called the personal foul on Jason Capono, and that's Capono's second personal. We are here at the Staples Center for the Pacific Life Pac-10 semifinals. UCLA, the 8th seed, and Oregon, the 5th seed. Steve Fizioc, Marcus Johnson, Jim Watson, Bill McDonald, Dan Bowami here at Staples Center on Fox Sports Net. Our next contest will be, but the Bruins just playing a marvelous game with a 9-point lead on Oregon, a team that beat the Bruins by 31 less than a month ago. Joseph fighting for it, and then he is knocked out of bounds. And we have a whistle Oregon will have the basketball when we come back. 15-15 left. Bruins by 9.
These people are getting answers to the most important questions they'll ever ask. Questions about their health. They're finding those answers in a single place. WebMD. 16 million people come to WebMD every month. They find vital information that used to be scattered in 100 locations, now all in one place. The place America comes for healthcare answers. A place called WebMD.
Today, we showed this grandfather how he could count on long-term care insurance to be there for him. If he ever needs it.
My baby don't care for.
Gentlemen, KFC is something unique and exciting. Hot wings.
Hot and crispy outside, tender inside. Hot wings only from KFC. Get 8 for only $2.99 or 20 for just $7.49.
I smell hot wings.
A brilliant sun. Virgin sand that stretches for miles. And not another soul to bother you. Because there are 1,000 ways the Marzouk Desert can kill you. And that's a deterrent.
Are you tough enough to drive a Tacoma?
Welcome back to Staples Center, the Pacific Life, Pac-10 semifinals, game one, UCLA and Oregon. Ray Young and the Bruins with a nice lead right now, deep into the second half. Coming up a little bit later, semifinal number two. It is USC and California, the winner of this one against the winner of that one.
Thank you, Jim, and there it is, USC in California. But what a year this has been. A roller coaster-like season for Steve Lavin. It's USC getting ready. But Steve Lavin, he's like Lazarus. Yeah. He's rising. Bill Plaschke of the LA Times wrote a great story today, and he said, we know that tournament time affects Steve Lavin as darkness affects a vampire. He comes alive. He spins on those who have spent the winter pursuing him and scares them clear into the next season. He's doing it again, scaring the Pac-10 tournament invites from the 8 seed position.
I hate it when sports writers try and wax poetic.
Oh.
No, that was good. That was good stuff. I like that. I like that. I'm just a real cynic tonight.
Yes, you are. Jackson has been very cold. Only had 4 points in the first half and has 2 for 7 from the floor now.
And now they're starting to pay more attention to Ray Young. Double team that time on his penetration baseline. Dijon Thompson, you pass the offensive baton to Dijon. He's got Andre Joseph, a sizable height advantage, but why does he pull him out 30 feet from the basket? That negates all of that size.
Cummings scores. The lead is 11.
Oregon, again, they've got to try and get Luke Jackson, I think, more involved in this game. Dijon Thompson, a fine defender, is doing a nice job making things difficult. And Andre Joseph is another guy. He's got Jason Capone on him. He can take him off the dribble.
Robert Johnson can't finish. This has just been a miserable 5 minutes for Oregon. And Ryan Hollins inside will score. The lead is 13. Who are these Bruins?
Getting out in transition, playing good solid defense, making smart decisions in transition, even though I thought DJ may have given it up to TJ Cummings. On the right side, it all worked out their favor. But
Ridenour says it's my turn.
Okay, nobody else is going to step up. Andre Joseph, you don't want the ball. Luke Jackson, you're struggling. I'm taking it all upon my shoulders, and he can do it. He can get it done.
He's the Pac-10 most valuable player this year. Cummings trying to take his man Johnson, and he pulls right over, but no foul called. Loose ball's picked up by Ridenour.
So they tried him back. You can hurt him in transition right now.
Joseph. Long. Jackson. Threw it away, and Cummings has the basketball. It is been a relentless UCLA defense. The Bruins lost to Oregon, remember, by 31 points in their last game. But remember, UCLA lost by a combined 71 points in two games to Arizona, and they knocked them off last night.
And Ray Young really feeling that point guard position.
Like, relax, slow down. Come on, set it up. Give me the ball. I got this.
He is really growing into the position.
And he carried the basketball. It's a double dribble. Oregon will have it down by 10 with 12 minutes and 39 seconds to play. Dan Guerrero has Steve Lavin making the decision tougher and tougher. I mean, he was out the door. I'm sure Steve Lavin picked up the LA Times, read T.J. Simers. He wrote that the way UCLA springs the magic late, fans are going to the Final Four in New Orleans with bumper stickers that will read, honk if you're behind Lavin all the way.
Yeah, it's going to be difficult if they continue this magic. Dan Guerrero played baseball at UCLA in the 70s. He knows all about the tradition. Steve Lavin trying to make the decision a tough one for the AD. In his first year, no less. I mean, how many times do you fire the football coach, Bob Toledo, whose team finished 7-4, and the basketball coach in the same year? That's a tough position for a first, for any AD to be in, especially a first-year AD.
But you know what's remarkable about Steve Lavin? He has made. He feels he will be gone. He has made the transition so easy for the athletic department because of his personality.
At the team banquet Monday night, had an opportunity to blast the athletic department people and didn't do it. Spoke nothing but the kindness and love and gratitude. But you know inside, Steve Lavin is hoping for that miracle. This team just turns that corner, gets on that serious roll. In some way, somehow, the miracle happens. He's able to hang on to his job.
Ian Crosswhite makes it a 9-point game as he makes one of two, 8 points for Crosswhite.
Steve Lavin chooses to rest Ray Young at this stretch. 12-12 left in the second half. Bruins up nine. You know, I really keep an eye on this score. You get Oregon State on a little run, two buckets in a row, I get Ray Young right back in there. And resting no more than two and a half minutes at the most.
Lavin, with his arms crossed, was yelling out at Ryan Walcott, who's the new point guard, reverse the ball, reverse the ball. Cummings.
T.J. Better. You got a big guy, Ian Crosswhite, trying to defend you at the top of the key. Oregon slow to help on that penetrating drive. Nice job by T.J. Smart play. Williams is doing a much better job defending the perimeter. I'm talking about Rittenau. I'm talking about Davis. Well, I was talking about Davis.
James will miss the three. And a foul is called against the Oregon Ducks. A lot more fouls against Oregon than against UCLA.